Name confused by Enchanted Nightingale. Chapter 20, Spider's Web. Events like this, it was harder to blend in, fade in the background, no matter how much both Mycroft and his magical shadow wanted to. Their presence in such events was regular. They would eat and drink, and mostly they would socialize with the aim to spin a web and drop potential victims in. No one really knew exactly what Mycroft did, not even those that prided themselves on being well-informed. But when a duke, or the prince, when the lass attended such meetings, always visited Mycroft's side at least once to talk and joke with him, that was the bait that drew the other insects in. It was a macabre game, the green-eyed wizard always thought this, but just the same, he watched with morbid fascination how Mycroft worked them to his tune. They needed connections if they wanted to stay well-informed and into the thick of things. The wizard usually adopted the attitude he used to on the parties thrown for his sake after the war. He smiled, he flirted and complimented, and did a bit of his own socializing, establishing contact with various people, from those in charge of the catering and the pianist to the bit overweight daughter of that Chinese diplomat or that timid trophy wife of the undersecretary to the American embassy. He never went for the big fish. They had nothing to offer him that he could not get with money. Plus, he could not stand the pretentious atmosphere for long, and added to that, it was less suspicious for him to not be seen around the big mains. Those people were better handled by Mycroft anyway. That man could make them jump easily enough, and he enjoyed it too. It was 2 hours into the soiree that Mycroft managed to approach his employee. "This evening is duller than I expected," the Muggle man remarked, making the green-eyed man's lips quirk upward.
"Like watching a documentary about wildlife,"
the wizard commented. "Two predators in a field of sheep?" Mycroft asked.
"Oh, there are many predators here tonight," the green-eyed man disagreed. "It just happens that we are also venomous."
Mycroft's eyes revealed just how amused he was by that comment. He had not thought of it before. He was a predator amongst many, but he had to stand out somehow, and the wizard's comment was spot on.
"I'm not sure if I should be flattered," he finally settled for.
"You should," the wizard replied, "because at the end of this evening we are walking away much richer than these idiots."
"You found something interesting," Mycroft stated.
"I guarantee you will like my morning report. Now, excuse me, the pianist is about to take a break, and young Miss Patel is scanning the crowd for you. Her father is an oil tycoon, correct?"
"The only plus about her," Mycroft replied. "Wish me patience, because clearly I have no luck."
The wizard offered a smirk, and they parted ways.